Welcome back to Satisfactory. I think we finally got that intro. I want to give you a sense of where we're going to be building. So this is obviously our main Crater Lakes build area, where most of our stuff has been put into place. And we are dropping in over here towards this new area where there's nitrogen being produced. And normally I would bring the nitrogen over, but I think in this case we'll bring everything else out and build things that we need with nitrogen right here. First step, let's find where we want to build. Get some foundations going. I want to see if this 4-meter foundation is too thick for this. Sometimes it lets you go and sometimes it doesn't. Yeah. So we need to use a thinner foundation. Let's use 2 meters maybe to start. See if that works. Okay, well maybe I just need to, oh wait, maybe it's not letting me build it because I haven't built the, yeah, I haven't built the resource well yet. Let's grab some wire out of storage here. Man, it's not going to let me build this until I power it as well. Luckily, I have some relatively localized power. Somewhere around here, I know I have power that I've run in from before. There's water over here. Interesting. I don't think I knew that. let's move this power back a little bit. Finally. It's right on a place where I won't ever be able to pick that up. I don't know if that's enough. So now I'm questioning if the 4 meter is too deep. Whatever we build, I think we want to build it kind of in this direction, right? Nitrogen max flow rate. That's a lot. We'll get that out of the way. And I think what we'll do is we'll build a little target zone for where we want this nitrogen to land. My inventory must be full. Nitrogen gas. It fills fast. It doesn't require any pumping. It's pretty easy to deal with as far as that goes compared to water. Ow. It really didn't do a ton of damage. Just about to finish up all the foundations and nozzles. Regarding this part, oh, boo. Wow. These trees are very resilient. Okay, well, if that's the case, maybe we need to build it on this side. One twenty. Lots of 120s. If I double it, it goes up to 300. There's almost no chance I need that much. How much nitrogen am I really gonna need? Is what I'm thinking about. take a peek at the heat sink. Technically, we need the nitrogen next. We don't need it right now. That's where it starts to kick in. $45 per minute per machine. Ooh, that's a lot actually. If we want to do 20 per, then that's 450 nitrogen per minute. That's a significant amount of nitrogen. But I think we'll figure that out later. I might want to just take over this whole area. Overdid it just a little bit. Uh-oh. Three spitters have found their way up here. We're gonna have to specify these lands. So I'm envisioning a couple of machines, maybe a few monoliths being built. Maybe we'll have fun with it and have like a little strip here where nothing is built. We'll kind of electrify these foundations. One gives us the ability to hover. Two gives us the ability to connect monoliths when we're ready to go. And I'm thinking right in this corner is where we're going to put our heat sink monolith. Maybe I should give myself two spaces. We'll bring it out to here. Nope, that's actually three spaces, depending on how you count it. As usual, when building vertically, you need to make sure that you have power. When I originally built this, I said 3 tall. But I think I'm going to go 4. It's still only going to be 1 belt's worth, and it's not really going to improve anything, except the calculation was like 3.4. So the only way to make use of that 0.4 is to just build 4. Oh yeah, I need to build a hypercannon out here. Where do we want to put that? This building's actually going to be large. Because we're building 4 of these. So it's going to be 1, 2, 3, 4. That's the edge. And home base is that way. We're missing some iron plate. Build this hyper cannon, but let's give it a little bit of style, shall we? I'm thinking we'll ramp it up a little bit, kind of block it off. Start at least at or above the tree line. And let's see if we can get a little bit of a belt in place here. So, you know, you want to accelerate into the hypercannon as much as possible. Until you don't. But in this case, I think we do. It's too many trees in the way. We need an inverted 4 meter. Let's give it this try. Test out our new hypercannon. I think it works great. Now let's target back to where we were. We just don't want to lose too much momentum. I'm worried by the fact that one level of that building has red lights and one level has yellow lights. That's potentially bad news. Ah, I didn't put the recipe in that section. One, two, three. So one more. Man, I brought just enough wire out. That's weird. I normally don't limit myself like that. Ooh, we might not have enough concrete as well. Okay, good to know. Uh-oh, what have I done? Let's connect this side since it looks like it's more straightforward. Oh yeah, I just need to connect this right here. Hello? Whoa. Maybe I need to put a little bit of power out here so we can hover out here a little better. Okay. So now it's just a matter of providing these guys copper sheets and aluminum sheets. They want all the sheets. Any chance I have some copper sheets on me? Let's run a test here. This is the fun way to climb this building and get to the top. Hypercannon's a bit overkill for this, but it does get the job done. Hey, we're making heat sinks. This level's not even connected with the recipe. I'll have to make sure I go back and tweak the blueprint to include the recipe. I probably should have put two belts of aluminum sheets in this blueprint. Though I am a little curious as to why is it... How are they not even getting down the first level? Something is not right. There's got to be a slow belt or lift somewhere in this system. Mark twos. Well, that'll do it. So glad I tested this first column of the monolith before we committed to a huge build. It would have been harder to see and it would have been harder to fix if it were all packed in and good to go. Man, I really went in for the Mark IIs for some reason. That's okay, a little debugging. Still way faster than building this by hand. I mean, my expectation is that I'll see non-stop flow of the insert material. Yeah, like that. Now I'm worried about every aspect of this thing. I mean, I wouldn't expect that at that point right there, it would be such a small amount of aluminum sheets, but I guess half enough times and it will wreck it. So the first machine gets 780 divided by 2 divided by 2 divided by 2 divided by 2 divided by 2. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 divided by 2, 6. That one's only getting 12 per minute on the initial run. Once everything fills up, then, you know, that's how you get better distribution. But the point that I think I should be making is, does the bottom machine get material? We probably didn't have enough to get all the way down here, but obviously some sheets made it all the way to the bottom. I don't have any more copper sheets. Out of concrete. How many are we making right now? Seven point five times six times three, 135 per minute. I think we need a bigger one. I was tempted to just say call it a day, but I think we need to complete. But, before I do that, I should fix our known issues. Let's do that, and we'll use this as an opportunity to grab some more concrete. Which means I should probably empty my inventory a bit. Let's see, concrete, but we also wanted to hit the blueprint designer, so we'll jump just past this power storage facility. I believe we've got the blueprint designer for this already in place. I should have kept some of the aluminum. Oh, look at that. Things are working for me today. Let's see, we don't need any more industrial fluid buffers, and we can drop power lines from the list. And we probably don't need power poles. Okay. It looks like these are on the same level, but they're actually part of two separate blueprints. The top of this blueprint and the bottom of this blueprint. I think I'll build it. Should I build it just like this? No, if I build it this way, we'll have more room at the top to do the distribution and collection. So I think this is the right way. Wait a minute. Did that rotate on me? It looks like this one rotated. Yeah, I totally rotated that one. At least this last one also rotated. It looks like every other one rotated. I don't like this. Somebody thinks they're helping me. Oh, I forgot to put the recipes back in the blueprint. Darn. Really should have remembered to put that recipe in, but that's okay. It's easy to fix. Plus, we are going to test this before we put the facade in place. Just a little bit annoying. Okay. Oh, wait. Let's put in the lifts and then we'll call it. Okay, that's looking good. All the lights are yellow. And now we've got plenty of room to put in our distribution centers and collection centers. And then we'll just put in a nice little facade and we're done. We've completed this. But for now, we're gonna start here, and then I think the next thing we wanna put in is the cooling system. So they make use of, I could make use of engines, but if I use engines, that's gonna take more. Well, actually it takes fewer heat sinks per minute. This one takes 12 per minute. This one takes 9 per minute. So I think this is actually better. We'll ship out some motors and we'll make cooling systems. And that way we can just use our nitrogen gas for that purpose. We'll see how interesting it's going to be. I mean, we're going to have to figure out 9-to-1 ratio. Well, 9-to-2. That's pretty rough. We might need 2 levels of input for heat sinks. We'll see. But I think that is all we need for the heat sink part of this build. It's functionally correct. It's going to be interesting putting in the facade in this is going to be interesting. That's all I'm going to say. these corners are going to be, it's going to be rough. Might have to come out to something like this. But we'll see. It's going to be interesting. But it's going to be interesting in the next episode. Thanks for hanging out. I do appreciate it. We'll see you next time.